Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum everyone. We are back for lecture number 16 for English comprehension and composition. In the previous lecture, we talked about the pre-writing techniques in a lot of detail. All the possible pre-writing techniques were discussed in the previous lecture. Today, we are going to talk about the same pre-writing techniques with activities and examples. We have added some student samples to each pre-writing technique so that you have a very clear idea how you have to do it. And it would be a very good idea if you try every pre-writing technique once at least with yourself and get it checked by someone so that you know what can be the possible mistakes that you make. And by doing that practically once or twice, or practicing it for at least two times, you will have a very clear idea what that pre-writing technique actually is and how you have to go about it. So let's move on to the same pre-writing techniques that we talked about in the previous lecture, but with a lot more detail, with activities and with examples. Pre-writing techniques are these five basic techniques that you must know by now: free writing, note keeping, brainstorming, mind mapping and journalistic questions with one how and five W's. Now, only note keeping is slightly different here. But that is one thing that is very simple, and we are going to talk about it now. Now, what actually is pre-writing? Pre-writing is the first stage of the writing process aimed to discover and explore our initial ideas about the subject. So that is basically the initial ideas where you discover and explore what is already there in your mind. You put it to a piece of paper or उसके बाद आप उसे ऑर्गेनाइज करते हैं, उसमें से आप इंपॉर्टेंट पीसेस ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन जो है वो निकालते हैं. एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ राइटिंग इट इज़ यूजुअल टू फाइंड योरसेल्फ टोटली ब्लैंक विदाउट आइडियाज अबाउट व्हाट टू से. प्री राइटिंग टेक्निक्स मेक इट मच ईजियर टू स्टार्ट अ राइटिंग. इट्स वेरी वेरी कॉमन दैट व्हेन यू आर गिवन अ टॉपिक टू राइट, you are totally blank, you have no idea what to write about. So it's quite normal, and pre-writing techniques are used to avoid that. They make it easier for you to think about your topic, to explore whatever is there in your mind and bring it out on a piece of paper. Once it is there in black and white, so uske baad aap usme se apni related information alag kar lete hain aur ek acha jo piece of writing hai wo create karte ki koshish karte hain. Now, first kind of pre-writing is free writing. Free writing is like pouring all of your thoughts onto paper. Don't take your pen off the page, keep writing for the entire time. If you don't know what to write, write "I don't know what to write" until you do. Now, free writing is like thinking about what you have in your mind and pouring all your thoughts onto the piece of paper that you have. Now, one important thing regarding free writing is that you are not supposed to take your pen off the page. You just keep on writing, concentrating on what the topic is for the entire time that you are asked to write. If you don't know what to write, write "I don't know what to write" until you do. Whatever is there in your mind, even if it's the grocery list, even if it's the movie that you watched last night, जो भी दिमाग में है आप लिखते जाएं. With time, you will definitely realize कि कुछ ना कुछ mind में आपके आ रहा है. Don't try to sort good and bad ideas. At this point in time, you're not supposed to get into the details of relevant or irrelevant, good or bad, important or unimportant. यहाँ पर जो भी mind में आ रहा है, you just keep writing. It will be a later stage where you will pick up the important points here. Don't worry about spelling and grammar. This is also one very fun activity, in the sense that students who are weak in grammar or spelling, they don't have to worry about that. वो बाद में जब उसी free writing से अपना essay लिखने शुरू करें तो अपने spelling errors वगैरह ठीक कर लें, लेकिन इस time पे उन्हें spellings के बारे में परेशान होने की ज़रूरत नहीं होती. Now we have an example, a student sample that was produced in the form of free writing. It is a memorable moment. The student was asked to write about a memorable moment, to free write about it. So ye unhone likha, "The day I got my driver's license, Now, this is not a complete sentence. आपके free writing में ये important बात है कि आपके sentences बेशक complete ना हो. Anything related to the topic that comes to your mind, you're supposed to write. Even if it's just words, phrases, chunks of words, chunks of sentences, fragments हैं. Even run-on sentences would do. आप वो लिखते जाएं. Because बाद में आप उनको correct करके सीधे straight sentences बना के अपना paragraph बना सकते हैं. Cloudy, raining. Now, the memorable moment for this person is the day they got their driver's license. Now, they are describing the day. Cloudy, raining, crummy taste in my mouth. Of course, the person was a little nervous. Nervous stomach, sweaty hands, exam room. Crowded, people pushing, smoking, waiting in line for eternity. Eternity means बहुत ज़्यादा time के लिए, because इतने ज़्यादा लोग होते हैं कि आपको इंतज़ार करना पड़ता है. Dirty floor, carved up desktops. Now we don't have complete sentences. इसमें complete sentence एक भी नहीं है. You can write complete sentences, but try to avoid them, because जब आप complete sentence लिखने लगते हैं तो आपका ध्यान उसके structure की तरफ चला जाता है और वो free writing से ध्यान हट जाता है. So try to be very specific and focus on just writing phrases or pieces of information, that too in the paragraph form. Now you can see in this slide that your free writing is in the paragraph form. In the previous lecture I told you that it is, and now you can see that it is. Dirty floor, carved up desktops, waiting and waiting, still in line, candy wrappers on floor, people next to me looked poor, dirty t-shirts, everyone seems older than me. My written test graded, passed, thanks I said, he ignored me, just looked straight ahead. Next he mumbled, wait in line for vision test. Now before the vision test it was the written test. When it was marked, the person was passed, and he or she was sent over to the vision test, and people were loud, rude and nervous, and they were standing in line getting angry at waiting. Been here 3 hours, said a scruffy looking kid. Now this little kid said that he has been there for 3 hours. Tough faceless eye examiner. Passed, go to the next line. Thank you, no response. Thanks a lot, still no response. Important moment for me. Now he's also talking about the people being not very with emotions. They are very blank. Twice he said thank you and there was no response. Now you can see there are not a lot of spelling mistakes, but you see we have punctuation problems here. E capital hai lekin full stop nahi hai, so this is one thing. Then all phrases are ended with full stops and start with next capital letters, or कोई भी complete sentence नहीं है. So these are the things that you have to be very careful about. आपको free writing में grammar, spelling की बिल्कुल कोई परवाह नहीं करनी है. That's one secondary element that is least important at this point. Now you can see that this person regarding a memorable moment in their life, उससे related उन्होंने all possible information यहाँ इकट्ठी कर दी है. तो when they pick up sentence pieces of information from here, उनको complete sentences बनाते हैं कुछ additions करके, तो ये एक बहुत अच्छा comprehensive पैराग्राफ बन जाएगा अबाउट द पर्सन्स मेमोरेबल मोमेंट इन लाइफ, द डे दे गॉट देयर ड्राइवर्स लाइसेंस. सो दिस इज हाउ यू डू फ्री राइटिंग. इसमें कोई ग्रामर की रिस्ट्रिक्शन नहीं होती. आप कंप्लीट सेंटेंसेस भी नहीं लिखें, आप सिर्फ फ्रेजेस वर्ड्स लिखें, सो दैट योर ऑल योर थॉट्स कम ओवर टू योर पीस ऑफ पेपर. Now this is a practice for you. Get ready, get your pen and notebook ready. You have to free write for 3 to 5 minutes on the following topic. What is the most embarrassing experience you have ever had? Now I hope you understand the topic. You have to write about the most embarrassing experience you have ever had. Just aisa experience jisme aapko bahut sharmindagi hui ho. जो आपकी लाइफ में कभी हुआ हो उसके ऊपर आपको फ्री राइटिंग करनी है. 3 to 5 minutes, टेक 5 मिनट्स, डू इट एंड फॉलो द रूल्स जो फ्री राइटिंग के हैं. राइट इन पैराग्राफ फॉर्म, राइट इन फ्रेजेस एंड चंक्स फॉर्म, नॉट कंप्लीट सेंटेंसेस, एंड डोंट वरी अबाउट ग्रामर एंड पंक्चुएशन. So start your free writing, and then I'll show you a student sample, and we'll see where things are wrong and how you have done it. Now I hope you're done with your free writing. Let's move on to looking at a student sample. It's written by a student, and let's see how they have done it. This is the most embarrassing experience of a person's life. Let's see what it is. At my cousin's wedding during the mehndi ceremony, almost 200 guests were present. The bride and groom were ready for the ceremony. All the girls were excited. I had to carry the biggest plate of mehndi decorated with rose petals and candles, was wearing heels, went to the stage to say something to the bride. While coming down, the heel stuck in the carpet fold, and I flew down with the plate of mehndi, fell with a thud and crash. All eyes on me, family rushed to my rescue, but people laughed, laughed too, especially kids. Didn't feel any pain, but felt the heat of extreme embarrassment and shame. Later on, laughed my heart out with my cousins and family. The incident makes me laugh even now. Now, this was a very brief explanation, a very easy explanation of an embarrassing moment of this person's life. And you can see that there are visible spelling mistakes, punctuation ke problems hai, sentence structure ka masla hai. The person has ended their sentences or connected it with these three dots. Or yahan pe dekhe ceremony ke spelling galat hai. This is a very simple and easy expression of the most embarrassing experience of this person's life, and we can see that the person has made some visible errors in punctuation, in spellings, in sentence structures, but they are not important. The most important thing is that they have gathered a piece of information on here showing that they know what their embarrassing experience is. Aur agar isko thoda sa refine करेंगे तो ये एक बहुत अच्छा पैराग्राफ जो है ये बन जाएगा. नाउ सी हियर द फर्स्ट फ्रेज और पार्ट ऑफ सेंटेंस इज सेपरेटेड बाय अ डैश, बट द रेस्ट आर ऑल अकंपनीड विद डॉट्स. कोई कैपिटल लेटर्स नहीं है. सेरेमनी की स्पेलिंग गलत है. 200 फिगर में लिख के आगे 100 लिखा है और उसके भी स्पेलिंग गलत हैं. द ब्राइड एंड ग्रूम वर रेडी फॉर द सेरेमनी. सेरेमनी के यहाँ स्पेलिंग गलत हैं लेकिन यहाँ ठीक हैं. दैट मीन्स द पर्सन वॉज रियली इन्वॉल्व इन फ्री राइटिंग और उन्होंने स्पेलिंग की परवाह नहीं की. वॉज वेयरिंग हील्स समथिंग. नाउ लेट्स सी वेयर एल्स द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ स्पेलिंग लाइज. स्पेशली के स्पेलिंग गलत हैं. Then embarrassment के spelling बिल्कुल ठीक हैं. Cousins के spelling गलत हैं. And the person has put in some emotion as well, that they fell down and they were embarrassed, and in the end they laughed a lot. So this is how you go about free writing. You can see that it's in the paragraph form, and there are phrases and sentences, parts of sentences that are connected. Now the next pre-writing technique that is new for you in this lecture is note keeping or keeping a journal. We did not talk about this pre-writing technique before. Keeping a journal is an excellent way to practice your writing skills. Your journal is mostly for you. It's a private place that you record your experiences and your inner life. It is the place where, as one writer says, I discover what I really think by writing it down. Now, note keeping or keeping a journal can be a pre-writing technique if you use that technique to before writing a piece. Otherwise, note keeping or keeping a journal ya koi diary wagera likhna, it's a very good habit if you want to become a good practicing writer. What you have to do is that you get a diary or a notebook aur usme rozana aap at least 15-20 minutes ke liye likhe. Write freely without any problems, without any tension of being correct, being accurate, because aapka journal aur aapki jo diary hoti hai wo personal hoti hai. Nobody else reads it. वो आपके लिए है. उसमें आप बिल्कुल गलतियों की परवाह नहीं करें. एंड देन वन राइटर सेज दैट इट्स अ जर्नल इज वेयर आई डिस्कवर व्हाट आई रियली थिंक बाय राइटिंग इट डाउन. व्हेन यू राइट दैट थिंग डाउन, आपके साथ बुरे दिन में जो भी हुआ उसमें से कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट बातें पिक करें और उन्हें लिखें. जब आप लिख रहे होते हैं तो ऑल दोज एक्सपीरियंसेस काइंड ऑफ फ्लैश इन फ्रंट ऑफ योर आइज, आपके माइंड में से दोबारा गुजरते हैं, वो आपको याद भी रहते हैं. एंड वाइल राइटिंग यू अंडरस्टैंड कि राइटिंग की टेक्निकलिटीज़ क्या हैं, and then you tend to become a very good writer. Some important points about how to keep a journal. You can keep a journal in a notebook. It can be a notebook, it's not necessarily a journal or a diary. Every morning or night or several times a week, write for at least 15 minutes in this journal. Har roz likhe ya din ek hafte mein do teen dafa likhe, lekin likhe zarur, at least 15 minute is journal ko likhe. Don't just record the day's events. Don't start with I got up in the morning, I got ready, I went to university or office, I did this, had tea or lunch at this particular time, came back. ये एक यूजुअल एक्टिविटी है जो जिसमें कुछ नया नहीं है, कुछ ऐसी बात नहीं है जो आपको याद रखनी हो. That is happening. Instead, write in detail about what most angered, moved or amused you that day. अब लिखना आपको किस चीज़ के बारे में है? Something that made you angry, something that moved you somehow, it touched you emotionally, and something that amused you, that made you happy, that made you excited about something. इन चीज़ों के बारे में लिखें, because emotions are one thing that are supposed to remain. Memories बन जाते हैं जो बाद में और जो आपको याद आते हैं. जब आप बाद में ये जर्नल पढ़ेंगे तो विद टाइम आप अपनी राइटिंग भी इंप्रूव कर सकते हैं और बहुत सी यादें आप रिकॉर्ड करेंगे. योर जर्नल इज प्राइवेट, सो डोंट वरी अबाउट ग्रामर और करेक्टनेस. सो जर्नल आपका प्राइवेट है, आपको किसी टीचर को चेक नहीं करवाना, उस पर कोई मार्किंग नहीं होनी, किसी एग्जाम में नहीं जाएगा, किसी न्यूज़पेपर में पब्लिश नहीं होगा. आपका जर्नल आपका अपना है, इट इज़ समथिंग दैट यू ओन, सो देर इज़ नो नीड टू वरी अबाउट ग्रामर और करेक्टनेस. Now let's look at example of a journal entry. Now this is September 7, 2011. एक student के journal entry है जो उन्होंने September 2011 की लिखी है और कुछ चार points में लिखा है और it's a very important day in their life, so उन्होंने उसको record किया. And you can see that it's emotion, full of emotion. It is very clear और इसमें गलतियाँ तो नहीं हैं, लेकिन बहुत अच्छा उन्होंने इसको organize किया हुआ है. The day started with waking up late for the convocation, quite unlike me. Now it can be anything, whatever you feel. It is their convocation day and they woke up late, and that was shocking, and it was quite unlike them that wo usually kabhi late nahi uthte hain. Finally arrived the convocation center in time and got to meet all classmates after a long time. Jab aapka convocation hota hai to aap university se farigh ho chuke hote hain, kafi time ke baad aap apne friends se milte hain aur aap excited bhi hote hain. It was a great feeling to receive my medal amidst roaring applause in front of an audience of almost 1200 people. So this again is a great full of emotion feeling, very excitement, excited, a very joyful event for the person was that they received their medal, and people were applauding for them, clapping for them. And there was an audience of almost 1200 people, and the person says that they missed their parents very much. Maybe they were not there at the moment, so they missed them. So this is a journal entry, a very common example of a journal entry. Any event that made you happy, that made you sad, that brought some kind of an emotion, you can record that in your diary. So when you keep doing that every day, every other day, with or without grammar mistakes, with time, jab aap saalon saal tak ye cheez karte hain to time ke sath sath aapki writing bahut improve hoti hai. You know how to organize thoughts, you know how to put them in black and white, aista aista wo cheez improve hoti hai. So writing a journal is one very important technique for improving your writing. The third technique is brainstorming. You already know about brainstorming. This is just a revision, but here we are going to look at student samples. Brainstorming is a strategy of listing all the terms related to the topic. No need to worry about whether those ideas are useful or not. You just jot down all the possibilities. The more, the better. Then look back things you have listed and circle those that make a sense to the topic. Often brainstorming looks more like a list, while free writing may look more like a paragraph. And this is one thing that we have already discussed. आपकी free writing जो है वो paragraph की form में होती है और आपकी जो brainstorming है that is in the list form. At this stage you are not supposed to worry about what is relevant, what is irrelevant, important or unimportant, and needed or not required. यहाँ पर आपको सिर्फ सारी possibilities or ideas ko note down karna hai. That's what you need here. With either strategy, your goal is to get as many ideas down on paper as you can. Whether it's brainstorming or free writing, the purpose is to gather as much information about the topic to on the piece of paper as much possible. Example of brainstorming. Now, this is a topic that is given to you to brainstorm on. What would I do with $1 million? And they have written about 7 points about it. Travel to Europe, Asia, South America, pay off our house. Pay off means uska jo debt hai ya jo karza hai wo de denge. Help friends financially. किसी फ्रेंड को हेल्प की ज़रूरत हो उनको पैसे देंगे. गो अब्रॉड फॉर स्टडीज़. शेयर एंड डोनेट टू चैरिटीज़. बाय अ लॉट ऑफ बुक्स. इन्वेस्ट, सेव एंड लेट द इंटरेस्ट ग्रो. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स दैट द पर्सन वांट्स टू डू विद $1 million. और आपने देखा कि ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग का रूल यहाँ पे फॉलो हुआ है. नो स्पेसिफिक ग्रामर इज फॉलोड. बुलेटेड पॉइंट्स में लिखा है और लिस्ट की फॉर्म में लिखा है. दैट इज़ वॉट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट. We just discussed that your brainstorming is in the form of a list and your free writing is in the form of a paragraph. So this is important. You have to be very specific about that. Aapki jo brainstorming hai wo list ki form mein honi chahiye. Now this is a practice for you. Pick up your pen and take out your notebooks and take 5 minutes to brainstorm ideas about the following question. What are some of the most memorable experiences of your life? Aur aapko ab tak samajh mein aana chahiye ki brainstorming kya hai, wo karni hai aapne. What are some of the most memorable experiences of your life par. Now I hope you're done with the brainstorming on this topic of some of the most memorable experiences of your life. Let's look at a student sample. This is what one of the students has written. Most memorable experiences of my life. Number one is receiving my first ever award for securing first position in the class. This is one very important memory, of course. When you are a kid aur aapko apni class mein first aane par inaam mile, toh that is one thing jo aapke mind se kabhi nahi nikalti. Going to Murray with friends in school, that must have been fun. Traveling in rain with classmates on my way back from a conference. Now you see yahan pe conference ki spelling mein problem hai, lekin that's just all right because at this stage you are not supposed to worry about any grammar problems or any structural spelling problems as well. Receiving my medal on convocation, losing a scholarship opportunity, losing ke spelling galat hain, opportunity ke spelling galat hain, same losing ke spelling dobara galat hain, both my parents in 1 year, that must be very hard, getting a new job exactly when I needed it the most. So these are some of the most memorable experiences of this person's life, and this is how you have to do it. This is brainstorming. Ye aapke points ki form mein aayenge. Aap complete sentences nahi likhenge aur aap paragraph ki form mein nahi likhenge. This is where brainstorming comes in. This was a student sample. Let's move on to mind mapping. This again is a very interesting technique. We'll show you a student sample as well. Mind mapping, clustering, mapping, idea mapping or webbing is a visual outlining. Ab mind mapping ke bahut se different naam hai. Clustering ke bare mein we talked about in the previous lecture. Mapping, that also is the same. Idea mapping or webbing. What you do is basically you make a web, that's why it can be called webbing. It is a visual outlining. It is an outline, but it is visual. It is in the form of a drawing. It is another way to organize your ideas. Start with your topic in the center and branch out from there with related ideas. अब आपका टॉपिक सेंटर में होता है और आप ब्रांचेस बनाते हैं उस टॉपिक से रिलेटेड आइडियाज़ की. यूज़ वर्ड्स एंड फ्रेजेस, नॉट कंप्लीट सेंटेंसेस. दिस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट माइंड मैपिंग. तो जब आपका माइंड मैप बनता है मिडिल में, आपके पास सर्कल में आपका मेन टॉपिक है और उसके इर्द गिर्द जो चीज़ें आप लिख रहे हैं वो सेंटेंस फॉर्म में हरगिज़ नहीं होती. दे आर आइदर वर्ड्स और फ्रेजेस, दे आर नॉट कम्प्लीट सेंटेंसेज. एंड वेन यू राइट कम्प्लीट सेंटेंसेज यू लूज क्रेडिट फॉर दैट. आपको मार्क्स जो हैं वो नहीं मिलते. इसलिए मेक श्योर दैट यू डोंट यूज़ इट. Okay, let's look at this example of a mind map. The topic is my future plans. वी हैव थ्री फ्यूचर प्लान्स, दैट इज फैमिली, स्कूल एंड वर्क. अब इससे रिलेटेड आपके फ्यूचर प्लान्स में सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट होगा फैमिली. ये एक स्टूडेंट के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से है, वो स्कूल में भी पढ़ रहा है, उसका स्कूल इम्पॉर्टेंट है, और तीसरी चीज़ है वर्क. सो फैमिली से रिलेटेड वी हैव वन और टू पॉइंट्स. सी, बी नाइसर टू माई लिटिल ब्रदर, डू वट माई पेरेंट्स टेल मी फर्स्ट, एंड स्पेंड मोर टाइम, दैट इज विद फैमिली. अब इसमें देखिए, आपके पास पूरे सेंटेंसेस नहीं है, फ्रेजेस में लिखा हुआ है, एंड इट्स वेरी क्लियर आपका जो फैमिली से रिलेटेड जो पॉइंट्स हैं वो उसके इर्द गिर्द आ रहे हैं. यू हैव नॉट पुट दिस पॉइंट हियर, और इसको इससे रिलेट नहीं किया, बिकॉज माई फ्यूचर प्लान से ये नहीं रिलेट होगा, ये फैमिली से रिलेट होगा. आपका फ्यूचर प्लान ये नहीं हो सकता कि आप अपने भाई से अच्छे तरीके से, उसके भाई के साथ अच्छा सलूक करेंगे. इट कैन क्लोजली रिलेट टू योर रिलेशनशिप विद योर फैमिली. सो दिस इज हाउ यू डू इट. नाउ अबाउट स्कूल, वी हैव दीज आइडियाज, इवेंचुअली गो टू कॉलेज, मेक गुड ग्रेड्स एंड प्ले बेटर इन स्पोर्ट्स एट स्कूल. तो स्कूल से रिलेटेड ये तीन बातें, एंड देन अबाउट वर्क वी हैव स्टॉप पुटिंग ऑफ असाइनमेंट्स एंड पे अटेंशन इन क्लास बेटर. सो दिस इज अ विजुअल आउटलाइनिंग एज यू वर टोल्ड बिफोर. इसकी इस तरह से ये हेल्प आउट करता है कि जब आप लिखने के लिए शुरू करते हैं अपनी असाइनमेंट और एसे और पैराग्राफ, यू स्टार्ट ऑफ विद brief introduction and then you move over to your future plans about family. और उसमें ये तीनों बातों को elaborate कर दें, your future plans regarding your studies and then about your work. तो उसमें तीन चार paragraphs का आपका essay जो है वो बहुत अच्छा develop हो जाता है. Now this is a practice for you. Pick up your pen and notebook and start making a map to organize your ideas about this topic, how to learn English. Now you will be given about 10 minutes for this because it's a very vast topic, और आप इससे related अपने जो ideas हैं वो लिखें, and then we come back and we'll show you a student sample that is very well made and you'll have a very clear idea how to do it. Okay, I hope you are done with your mind map of how to learn English. Let's look at a student sample and see how they did it. Here you are. This is a very well made student sample. We have how to learn English in the middle, and then there are four possible branches that are coming out. You learn English with the help of four important skills, that is listening, writing, speaking and reading. अब इन तीनों चारों स्किल्स से रिलेटेड उन्होंने अलग अलग इन्फॉर्मेशन जो है वो ब्रांच की, एंड देन दे हैव गिवन ईच स्किल अ कलर, और उससे रिलेटेड जो इन्फॉर्मेशन है उसको एक डिफरेंट कलर दिया है ताकि वो आसानी से समझ में आ जाए. सो लेट्स सी, लुक एट स्पीकिंग. स्पीकिंग से रिलेटेड उन्होंने तीन ब्रांचेस और बनाई हैं, वॉच टीवी ड्रामास, रिसाइटिंग सेंटेंसेस इवन आर्टिकल्स, एंड देन टॉक टू फॉरेनर्स. Now this is a very good example of how you can learn speaking. When you talk about English, it is based on four skills. Usme se speaking ke upar unhone ye teen branches, and then they have related these three branches or connected them with the same skill that they teach. Isko dusre skills ke sath attach nahi kiya hai. So you have to be very careful in this regard. कि आपका जो सेकेंडरी इन्फॉर्मेशन होती है वो उसी टॉपिक से रिलेटेड हो जिससे वो रिलेटेड है, जिसके बारे में वो है. सो मोस्टली स्टूडेंट्स व्हाट दे डू इज कि वो इन सारी बातों को कनेक्ट कर देते हैं ला के दरमियान में अपने टॉपिक के साथ, और वो एक तरह का वेब बन जाता है. इट्स नॉट दैट. What you have to do is कि आपको related information को उससे specific related information के साथ connect करना होता है. So speaking goes with watch TV dramas. Of course they can improve their speaking with this, reciting sentences, even articles, and talking to foreigners. When you talk to foreigners, of course you are exposed to very क्लियर नेटिव एक्सेंट एंड इंग्लिश, तो वो आपको हेल्प करती है कि किस तरह से आपने इंग्लिश बोलनी है. देन द सेकेंड स्किल इज रीडिंग. रीडिंग के साथ उन्होंने दो इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज़ों को रिलेट किया है जो कि येलो बॉक्स में है, और उसके साथ फर्दर दो चीज़ों को रिलेट किया है जो ग्रीन बॉक्सेस में है. द टू थिंग्स इज एक्सटेंसिव रीडिंग एंड इंटेंसिव रीडिंग. ये दो किस्म की रीडिंग होती है. एक्सटेंसिव रीडिंग इज Let words flow without checking or reviewing. Cover various materials, novels and journals. Now, extensive reading is when you pick up a book, start reading without thinking कि इसमें आपका meaning क्या है, आप क्यों पढ़ रहे हैं and all that. Pleasure reading के लिए या वैसे ही आप reading करते जाएं. और intensive reading includes analyze and see how to organize an article in a logical way. एक आर्टिकल को ये सोच के पढ़ें कि वो लॉजिकली किस तरह से कनेक्टेड है, हु रोट इट, व्हाई दे रोट इट, फॉर व्हाट ऑडियंस इट हैज बीन रिटन एंड ऑल दैट. एंड देन कलेक्टिंग वेल रिटन सेंटेंसेस आउट ऑफ दैट आर्टिकल और एनीथिंग दैट यू आर रीडिंग, उसको क्लोजली एनालाइज करें और उसमें से अच्छे लिखे हुए सेंटेंसेज अलहदा करें. एंड चेक वर्ड्स अननोन, जैसे हमने रीडिंग कॉम्प्रिहेंशन में पढ़ा, वर्ड्स इन कॉन्टेक्स्ट, वोकैबुलरी इन कॉन्टेक्स्ट चेक करें, आपको जो वर्ड्स नहीं आते उनके अनफेमिलियर वर्ड्स के मीनिंग्स जो हैं वो ढूंढें. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट रीडिंग. रिगार्डिंग लिसनिंग दे हैव कनेक्टेड थ्री मोर आइडियाज विद इट, पॉप म्यूजिक, न्यूज़ फ्रॉम BBC, CNN एंड TV ड्रामाज एंड फिल्म. वैन यू लिसन टू पॉप म्यूजिक इन इंग्लिश दैट हेल्प्स यू डिवेलप योर लैंग्वेज अलॉट. एंड देन न्यूज़ BBC इंग्लिश आप सुने जो कि ब्रिटिश इंग्लिश है, CNN से सुने जो कि अमेरिकन इंग्लिश है. TV ड्रामाज और फिल्म ये जब आप देखेंगे इंग्लिश में तो आपकी लिसनिंग बहुत इम्प्रूव होती है. And similarly, writing, jotting down ideas, keeping a diary, reading to see how others write. This again is a very good, well-made cluster or mind map, because writing also tells us that if you whatever ideas come to your mind, you just jot them down like brainstorming. तो उससे आपकी writing improve होती है. Keeping a diary, जो मैंने अभी आपको बताया, अगर आप हफ्ते में दो बार भी उसको 15-15 मिनट के लिए लिखते हैं, तो that will help you in improve or enhance your writing skill in a very good way. And then reading or analyzing written texts to see how others write. Unka style, unki approach, purpose, ye sab jab aap note karenge, analyze karenge, toh that will improve your writing skills. So this was a very good example of a mind map that a student had organized. And you can have a very clear idea how you have to go about your mind maps. And I hope you now can look at your mind map and compare it with this one and see कि आपने कहाँ mistake की है. अगर किसी किस्म का कोई connection का problem है जो आपने गलत जगह पर topic को branch out किया है, that's where you have to be very careful, because आपका जो topic है उसमें secondary जो चीज़ें हैं उनसे related आपकी tertiary चीज़ें आनी चाहिए. For example, these blue boxes are secondary pieces and then the yellow ones are उनसे related जो बातें हैं वो हैं. So this is how you have to go about a mind map. I hope yours was close enough, and let's move on to the last pre-writing technique is journalistic questions, how and 5 W's. Journalistic techniques refer to asking yourself 6 questions: how, what, where, when, which and who. Now here one question is extra, that is which, जो कि आपकी पहले वाली journalistic questions technique में नहीं था. And when we add how with it, it is the last pre-writing technique that we are going to talk about in this presentation is journalistic questions, how and 5 W's. First of all, we have how, then we have what, where, when, which and who. These are the 6 questions that you can ask to explore a topic better and gather some information. With these questions, you can fully explore ideas about the topic you are about to write and put everything down in detail. In this process, you should not spare hard efforts on every question, but make it as flexible as possible. We talked about this in detail before, that not all questions would apply to all topics that you're supposed to write about. Kuch questions kuch topics se relate karenge aur kuch bilkul relate nahi karenge. So you have to keep yourself very flexible and see if the questions relate to your topic, you can easily use them to gather information. In other words, some W's such as what or who should be attached with importance, while others such as where or who can be ignored. This largely depends on your topic. Now, this totally depends on your topic कि आपको कौन कौन से questions जो हैं वो select करने हैं, और 2-3 questions भी हों तो आप उनकी कुछ specific information आपको उस चीज़ से related जो है वो मिल जाएगी. Now, look at this example of journalistic questions. It's about Osama bin Laden. What has happened to bin Laden? Where and when he was killed? Who killed him? How did the US Army track that man down? अब ये questions देखें, आपके WH words से शुरू हो रहे हैं. What, where, who, how? On hearing the death of bin Laden, how did Americans respond? How did they celebrate? ये भी हाउ वाला क्वेश्चन है, ये भी हाउ है. व्हाट वाज द रिस्पांस ऑफ सिविलियंस इन अफगानिस्तान, व्हाट्स द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ द डेथ, हाउ कैन वी प्रिवेंट द पोटेंशियल टेरर एक्टिविटीज, एंड व्हाट शुड वी डू टू एलिमिनेट द टेररिज्म इन द लॉन्ग रन. नाउ दीज आर द क्वेश्चंस. अगर आप इनका दो दो तीन तीन लाइंस में भी आंसर करें तो इट कैन बी अ वेरी गुड शॉर्ट आर्टिकल रिगार्डिंग ओसामा बिन लादेन्स डेथ. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू एन एक्टिविटी दैट यू हैव टू डू. Again, you need your pen and notebook. Imagine you have heard about a robbery. A bag of diamonds is stolen and the owner is murdered. What journalistic questions would you ask to investigate? Now, you are asked to investigate this robbery, jiski kuch information aapko di gayi hai. A bag of diamonds is stolen and the owner is murdered. The rest of the information you have to investigate yourself. So let's do it. Take 5 minutes and make a list of questions that you will ask from anyone who was closer to the scene, ya police se, ya logon se, ya jo murder owner ka hua hai, uski family se. Aap jo questions poochenge, unki list banaye. Or it can be around about 7 to 10 questions. Or 5 to 10 questions, but they should be in journalistic questions form. Okay, now we have a student sample regarding this practice of journalistic questions. You keep your work in front of you and let's look at this sample and see how you have done it. At what time the robbery took place? Where did it happen? How many robbers? And any eyewitnesses? What weapon was used? What could be the reason? एनी सस्पेक्ट्स. सस्पेक्ट का मतलब होता है जिसपे शक किया जा रहा हो, लाइक द फैमिली कैन टेल यू कि उन्हें किस पे शक था. वट वर द डायमंड्स वर्थ, आई मीन डायमंड्स की कीमत क्या थी, कितने पैसों के थे वो. इफ इट वॉज अ बैग ऑफ डायमंड ऑफ कोर्स इट मस्ट बी वेरी एक्सपेंसिव. सो दीज आर द काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन यू कैन आस्क. इफ़ यू हैव मोर क्वेश्चन सी कि वो एक दूसरे से रिलेट किस तरह से करते हैं. और ये दिस इज़ वन पॉसिबल एग्जाम्पल. सो इफ़ यू हैव सिमिलर क्वेश्चन दैट्स वेरी गुड. यहाँ पर भी आपको ग्रामर और इस तरह की चीज़ों की कोई परवाह नहीं करनी है, बिकॉज यू कैन ऑलवेज गो बैक एंड करेक्ट इट लेटर. Now moving on to this particular document, this shows you the definition and example of pre-writing steps of brainstorming, clustering and questioning. These are three very commonly used pre-writing techniques. Let's look at what they are, and there are possible examples of all these three. So the examples would help you understand how you have to do it. Aur abhi tak jo aapne pre-writing ki hai uske sath aap isko match kare. And you will see where you are lagging behind, and you can always go back and improve that. Brainstorming, pre-writing technique of focusing on a particular subject or topic and freely jotting down any and all ideas which come to your mind without limiting or censoring information. Now brainstorming, aapko ab tak yaad ho jana chahiye ki wo kya hai. It's the jotting down of all ideas, all possible ideas on a subject in the form of a list. As compared to free writing, it is in the form of a list. Free writing is in the form of a paragraph. Now here you don't have to censor information. Censor ka matlab hota hai edit karna, nikal dena, delete karna. If it comes to mind, write it down. Ideas may be single words, phrases, ideas, details, examples, descriptions, feelings, people, situations. Do not write ideas in complete sentences. Yes, in brainstorming you have to avoid ideas in complete sentences. Topic is written and free associations are listed underneath. ना इसमें एग्जांपल देखें, आपकी आपके पास टॉपिक जो है वो तीनों काइंड्स के लिए कंप्यूटर्स का टॉपिक है. कंप्यूटर्स काइंड्स साइजेस यूजेस स्कूल गेम्स एंजॉय यूजिंग बिल गेट्स. नाउ बिल गेट्स ऑफ कोर्स इज वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट नेम रिगार्डिंग कंप्यूटर्स एंड यू दे हैव रिटन इट हेयर. तो आप इसको जब बाद में लिखें तो उससे रिलेट कर सकते हैं कि बिल गेट्स, हु इज़ बिल गेट्स. रिसर्च पेपर्स, इंटरनेट एक्सेस, फन टू वर्क विद, कंप्यूटर्स स्केयर मी, बिजनेस यूज, हॉस्पिटल्स, बैंक्स, पुलिस डिपार्टमेंट्स, डिफिकल्ट लैंग्वेज एंड क्लासेस टू लर्न हाउ. Now moving on to clustering. This the previous one was an example of brainstorming with a list of possible ideas regarding computers. The topic was computers and you have a long list of all the possible ideas, and then you can sit down and pick up the important ones, elaborate upon them and try to make a paragraph or essay. Now clustering basically is pre-writing technique of focusing on a particular topic or subject and freely writing down ideas, words, phrases, details, examples, feelings, situations, and descriptions. Do not limit or censor ideas. If you think it, write it. Do not write it complete, write in complete sentences. Clustering again is mind mapping. Uske andar aap complete sentences nahi likhte, that's totally wrong. Write topic on or subject in the center of your page. Let your mind make free associations and write these associations around your topic, branching out from the center. When finished with ideas, show cluster. Now, this is how you have to do it. Brainstorming and clustering is the same. You have to keep the topic in the middle and branch out all the possible details about it in the form of a web. Here is the example of a cluster. Like all the information that was in the form of brainstorming, they have put it right here in around this cluster. In the middle we have computers, then there are all the possible ideas related to it: kind, sizes, Bill Gates, Microsoft, scary, fingerprints, research, school use, mouse, money, classes for kids, papers, advertisements, games, etc. So this is how clustering works. Moving on to questioning again, pre-writing technique of asking who, what, where, when, why, and how. In order to focus ideas on a particular subject or topic, write topic or subject at top of page and list the questions down the left margin of page, leaving room for responses. Now what you can do is ke topic upar likhe hai, uske niche ek side pe left margin mein aap questions ki list bana le aur side pe thodi si jagah chhode taaki aap wo questions ke answers wahan likh sake. This technique may be done in two ways. Think of questions as a reporter writing an article and give details, information and ideas that will answer the questions effectively. The previous questioning technique jo humne ki, journalistic questions where I asked you to write about a robbery and investigate and write questions about a robbery, that is one thing jo aap ek reporter ki tarah kar sakte hain. And don't limit responses, make associations complete or ask your own questions about the topic or subject. And then don't limit answers. आप questions खुद भी पूछ सकते हैं, अपने questions इन 5-6 words के अलावा भी बना सकते हैं. That's not a problem. But what you have to do is that you have to you don't have to limit responses. उनको आप freely आने दें, जितने भी आपके mind में questions आते हैं. So let's look at example one for questioning technique regarding computers. We have questions of who. Bill Gates, engineers, word processors, technicians, programmers, hackers, and what? The next question is what? Build computers, program creators, hackers, abilities to destroy programs, instruction time to learn, and when? College education, high school courses, internet games and chat rooms, career decisions, work. So these are the three questions, who, what, and when, that can that has the possible answers in the list form, and you can always make them in sentences, change them into sentences, and write a comprehensive paragraph on computers. There are more. We have the question of where are the computers used. It can be phrased like that: college, high school, work, IBM building, Microsoft, rest of my life. Why? Money, fun, games, access to data, military intelligence, war games, knowledge, career move, prestige. So these can be the reasons for using computers. How? Scholarship, money from family, inherited skills, need to realize potential, career upward mobility, enjoy computers. Now how can computers be used positively? You can earn money for your family, you can get scholarships, you can get inherited skills. So these are all possible answers written to these questions. There is another example. You can ask questions like this as well. Example number two, computers. What do I know about computers? What would I like to know? When am I able to learn about them? where can I get more information? Why do I want this information? And why do I need this information? How will I use this information? How can I apply it? How will it benefit me? Now you see all six possible questions are used here. What, when, where, why, and how. So this is how you work with the questioning technique. You can use this technique to form questions in two ways, and those two ways we just demonstrated in front of you. This is one technique that helps you investigate on various topics. So I hope this handout helped you understand these three pre-writing techniques better: brainstorming, clustering, and questioning technique. Now moving on to another handout, we have pre-writing strategies for exploring ideas. This is a general handout. We have some very important techniques, not just pre-writing, because it's the time when we have read a lot about pre-writing techniques. You know on your you know them on your fingertips. You know what they are, how you have to go about them, how to use them, what to do and what not to do, what to avoid, and how you can be flexible about them. But in this handout, we have the basic information about what pre-writing is, why to bother about pre-writing, what are the reasons we need to use pre-writing techniques. Pre-writing refers to all the ways you begin your writing project. It includes coming up with ideas, organizing those ideas, and making a plan for your paper. Exploring ideas can include doing research, thinking, talking, free writing, listing, sometimes called brainstorming, clustering, sometimes called webbing or mind mapping. You know about free writing, listing and clustering, but doing research, thinking and talking, these are some general ideas that we are going to explore in this handout. It can also include any other way that you have for creating and writing down ideas for your paper. It's not just paper, it can be any piece of writing that you want to create. Why do we have to bother about pre-writing? Why not start off with writing exactly or immediately as soon as you get the topic? Pre-writing can help you think. Writing is a creative act of communication. Communicating means you have to have something to say, and that implies thinking. Unless you're someone who can hold the entire piece of writing in your mind, putting your ideas down on paper or the computer helps you collect and develop your ideas. Now, when you have to talk, you need to think. You just cannot pick up a piece of paper, remember it, and put all the words in your mind, or baad mein unko jaake kahin pe bol de. You need to keep thinking while you have to talk. So when you have to write, you have to think as well. So pre-writing is important because it helps you think. It gives you time to focus on what you want to write about, and you make an effort to think about it, you concentrate, and you put all the ideas on the piece of paper. Pre-writing can help you have well-organized, clear writing. Trying to write an outline or a draft before you have recorded any ideas is difficult. Using pre-writing strategies helps you to come up with ideas, organize those ideas, and develop a plan for your paper. Having a plan will lead to a well-structured writing assignment. Now, pre-writing also helps us become well-organized and create clear writing. Now, if you have not used any pre-writing technique, you won't be clear about what you are writing. So it's important that you use a pre-writing strategy that helps you come up with ideas, then you take some time to organize those ideas, and then plan your essay or any writing that you are creating. Pre-writing can save your time. Save you time. This may seem strange because you have to spend time doing the pre-writing. However, when you put ideas on paper, you have something to work with to create an outline, and an outline in turn makes writing your first draft easier. So when we say that pre-writing saves time, it's a little odd because aapko pre-writing pe bhi to time kharch karna hai. Lekin it's not odd in the sense it makes writing easier in the sense that when you have one or two pre-writing sessions, to aapka jo second your first draft hai wo बनना बहुत आसान हो जाता है. फर्स्ट ड्राफ्ट की स्टेज पे आपके पास टाइम बहुत बच जाता है. व्हेन यू ऑलरेडी हैव ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन अ पीस ऑफ पेपर, यू जस्ट क्विकली स्किम थ्रू, ऑर्गेनाइज इट एंड राइट इट डाउन. So there, that's where you save time. Furthermore, if your essay is better organized in the first draft, you can save time when you come to revise and edit your paper. जब आपका first draft जल्दी बन जाता है तो बाद में भी आपके पास time बचता है, because आपका first draft pre-writing techniques की वजह से अच्छा बन गया, and then you have to spend less time on the second draft and then the final paper. Pre-writing can produce better writing. Obviously, when you spend a lot of time on how you will gather information, what information you will gather, and how you will organize your essay, aapka jo writing hai, wo automatically ek behtar piece of writing ban ke saamne aayega. Now, what are some techniques for exploring ideas? We have already talked about many techniques for exploring ideas, but these are some of them. This is at the heart of the creative part of writing. There are many ways to come up with ideas. You need to find the ways that work for you. You probably already use some pre-writing techniques. For example, you probably begin by thinking about your topic. Now, let's see how they have showed us thinking about the topic. The topic is in the middle. Where can I find information? Aap foran sabse pehli baat jo topic ke bare mein sochte hain, that is, where can I find the information? What do I need to know? Then you start organizing ki aapko ye cheez pehle se pata hai, put it aside. Ye aapko nahi pata, ye kahan se milegi. So what do I know about this already? So what you already know, that is of course there with you, wo aapko pre-writing ke through apne paas jot down kar lena hai. What's interesting about the topic? Why does the topic appeal you? What interesting aspect can you highlight? What does my instructor want? And yes, this is very important. If your teacher has given you this assignment to write an essay or a paper or a project, so you have to be very careful that you have to analyze the expectations of your instructor. What does he or she want? And then what's my opinion? In the end, you have to say, okay, aapka apna opinion jo hai wo kya hai? So this is how you think. You start right from the time when your teacher announces in the class that he or she needs a particular assignment from your side in writing or an essay or a paragraph. You right from there, you start thinking about the topic, where do I get the information, how do I organize, when do I finish my work, what does the teacher expect. So ye questions aapke mind mein aate hai. So the thinking process starts right from there. Talk about your topic. After you have done some thinking, it's useful to talk about your topic with another student, or you might try to explain it to a learning center tutor or someone at home. You can talk about the topic to anyone. Talking about your topic and expressing your ideas can help you develop your ideas even if your listener does not know anything about the subject. Getting your listener to ask you questions is especially helpful. You can just in class, you are usually sitting in pairs. You can ask your partner or the friend sitting with you to ask you questions about the topic. So jo questions unke mind mein aayenge, that might be new for you. So you can answer those questions and gather all the possible information about your topic. So it's about talking about the topic. You can generate a discussion between group members. 5-6 logon ka group bana ke baith jaye aur usme aap topic ko discuss kare. Jab jitne zyada minds honge, utne hi acche naye ideas jo hain wo aayenge. Write down your ideas, and here comes the pre-writing technique. Sari pre-writing techniques jo hain wo likhne se related hain, unhe aap note karte hain. Isme aapke paas mind mapping aa jata hai. Take a piece of paper around whenever you are working on an assignment. Kahin bhi aapko kuch bhi yaad aa jata hai, aap us pe likhte jayein. You can sit among friends, aap discussion kare aur usme points add karte jayein. That's one very important thing. You can even go for mind mapping, free writing. दोस्तों से आप अपने टॉपिक से रिलेटेड फ्री राइटिंग करवाएं ताकि उनके माइंड में जो बातें उस टॉपिक से रिलेटेड हैं वो आपके पास भी आ जाएं. सो दिस इज़ हाउ यू गो अबाउट इट. Put brackets around them and use some other system to show which are your thoughts and which are the author's ideas for further help. Number three is set time aside and use a formal strategy for exploring ideas. Now, you have to give time to your writing. It's not that you are sitting in the class and you're just thinking about it, and in a blink of an eye you just have an assignment in front of you. It just not does not happen like that. You have to give a lot of time to your assignment. There are a number of specific strategies for exploring ideas. You may want to use several of them. The key is to put aside your inner critic or editor and write down all your ideas. Now, ye wali jo baatein hain, ye apply hoti hain hamari pre-writing techniques pe. We have given you an overview of all the possible pre-writing techniques. If you spend time on your writing, choose free writing, go for brainstorming, listing, looping, or journalistic questions and mind mapping, or kisi bhi do teen techniques se gather as much material for your writing as possible. And don't worry about whether or not you want them all to end up in your paper or not. At this time, you're not supposed to worry about the importance of these points that are coming. Begin by rereading your notes and then try one or more of the following strategies. Now, this is listing. This is also called brainstorming. Brainstorming or listing ki technique bilkul ek jaisi hoti hai. For exploring ideas simply means writing down everything you can think of about your topic. Don't write in sentences. That takes too long. Save time and write phrases. Don't worry about the order of the ideas or whether some ideas are general and others are details. You can sort that out later. Include questions you have about the topic. Ab is stage ke upar you can ask questions, you can add questions to the points you have listed. So ask yourself questions about your ideas to help you generate other ideas. Why is this the case? Why is it important? When did this happen? When does it matter? Where could this happen again? Who's involved? Who's affected? Who cares? What does this mean? What are the points, other points of view? How has it changed over time? How does it relate to X, or how does it relate to the person or anyone that is involved? So this is how you generate ideas, by asking questions. This is a kind of a combination of questioning and listing technique. Then we move on to free writing. Free writing again is to write for 4 or 5 minutes without stopping, without worrying about spelling, grammar or punctuation. And don't stop to read what you have written or make any corrections. Just don't stop. Just keep writing. If you reach a point where you can't think of anything, don't stop. Instead, write your last thought over and over until you have something else to write. At the end of the 5 minutes, read over what you have written and underline any parts you think have interesting ideas or ideas that might be useful to your paper. Write these in point form at the top of a new sheet of paper and then free write again for another 5 minutes. Now, this is again looping. Isme aap ek dafa free राइटिंग करते हैं, उसमें से इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स निकालते हैं, एंड देन ऑन वन ऑफ दोज पॉइंट्स यू फ्री राइट अगेन, एंड देन टेक आउट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स एंड फ्री राइट अगेन, और फिर उसी में से आप लूप करते जाते हैं और इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स को अलग कर लेते हैं. Clustering is another very important technique. Like listing and free writing, clustering helps you explore your ideas and expand on them. To begin to cluster, write your topic in one or a few words in the center of the page, then go on to write words that you think of when you think about that topic. For example, if your assignment was to write a paper about the influence of the United States on Canadian culture, and you had decided to write about the American impact on Canadian television, you might write TV in the center of the page. Circle TV and then write all the words that you associate with this topic, even words that at first may seem to be random. Now, if you were asked to write about the influence of the United States on Canadian culture, and one aspect that you have to focus is the effect of American impact on Canadian television, to middle mein aap TV likhenge aur usse related sari information uske ird gird likhenge. Even if it's random, that's all right. Write quickly, circling each word, grouping words around your central word or connecting them to whatever word you associated them with. When some new idea occurs to you, radiate it from the center word or from any word or phrase that the new idea flowed from. When you feel you have exhausted the ideas flowing from a word, go back to the word in the center of the page and begin again. Below is an example of a start on a pre-writing cluster. Now, this is a basic pre-writing cluster. We have TV in the middle, and we see one branch is comes out Canadians see more about US history than Canadian. Canadian TV imitation. Then we have Canadian actors go to Hollywood. Then we have Canadian attitudes affected by US. And these four different circles are again further divided. That is, Canadians see more about US history is CBC drama. Or uske saath ek aur point related hai, underfunded. Or question mark, whether it's not being given enough money. And then Canadian TV imitation. US ads, clothing fashions, Jeopardy, reality TV, and then another point, Canadian actors go to Hollywood ke saath koi related point nahi hai. Canadian attitudes affected by US, sex, guns, terrorism, these can be important aspects related to this point. So this is how this particular cluster would work. Often writers find that clustering helps them narrow their topic, then cluster again, this time starting with the narrowed topic at the center of the page. In the example above, this might look like taking Canadian TV imitation as the topic and working to expand those ideas through more clustering. Now, in this cluster, Canadian actors go to Hollywood has not been elaborated upon. So, isko aap ek alag box mein circle mein rakke iske upar mazid brainstorming jo hai wo kar sakte hain, mind mapping kar sakte hain. Now, categorizing is another important technique. Isme, what you do is, this method of exploring ideas is particularly useful for assignments in which some type of comparison is required. And this is a slightly less used pre-writing technique. Categorizing can also help you identify the views expressed by the authors of the articles and books you are reading. Moving on to categorizing, this method of exploring ideas is particularly useful for assignments in which some type of comparison is required. Categorizing can also help you identify the views expressed by the authors of the articles and books you are reading, which may lead you to find the thesis for your own paper. Now, this is a slightly more formal kind of research that you can do, and that is when you are writing a thesis or a term paper or anything, you have to go through a lot of reading material. आपको बहुत सी किताबें पढ़नी होती हैं, research articles पढ़ने होते हैं, और उसकी वजह से you have a lot of information with you and you simply have sometimes no idea how to categorize this. So categorizing की technique वहाँ use हो सकती. Below is part of one example which shows how categorizing can help you use or compare ideas and keep track of your own responses. इसमें देखें आपके पास world aid है topic और इसमें आप चार columns हैं और आपने दो authors की का article या book पढ़ी है. Who needs aid? First question है author A उसके बारे में क्या कहता है, author B क्या कहता है और my view क्या है, ये आपको इस document में पता चल रहा है. So author A says bottom billion of world's pop मतलब population. Author B, needy countries should decide who needs the aid. And my view, who, where are bottom billion? Like bottom billion कौन है? ये question जो आपके mind में आ रहा है, that is in the last column so that you can go back later and answer that question. Then the problem is according to author A, what is the problem? The aid doesn't go to most needy. World Bank not consulting countries. World Bank demands on poor economics causing problems. And then the second, author B thinks what the problem is. World Bank serves interests of donor countries, trade for aid demands, restructuring demands, ruin economies of receiving countries. Now the question in the author's mind is, would countries give aid if not attached to trade agreements? What are the aid trade agreements? Is a global body like World Bank needed? So these are the questions that the author asks, and author A or author B, dono ka point of view hai, jo ke aapne dekha, do columns mein organize kiya hua hai. Then in the end we have solutions, World Bank should consult with, aur ye aapko chota sa document jo hai, ye part mein dikhaya gaya hai. What comes next is, the purpose of all this is to help you think and get your ideas down on paper. You can do this by using all these pre-writing techniques or any two or three of them. And by doing that, you can develop all the possible ideas that can be useful later on to write in a better way. Till now we have discussed all the possible pre-writing strategies, pre-writing techniques with examples and with student samples. You have also been given activities that you did, and I hope they helped you with understanding of your own writing potential. I hope our discussion of all the pre-writing strategies has helped you to understand how you are to use your writing potential. We talked about all the possible pre-writing strategies, even starting from thinking, making an outline, and discussing your topic with your friends or with your teacher, that are very basic pre-writing strategies with which you can gather as much information as possible, and then you can go over to other more advanced pre-writing strategies that include brainstorming, mind mapping, journalistic questions, free writing, and keeping a journal, keeping notes with you, and these in turn will help you develop sufficient material for your upcoming writing work. Now, to quickly revise and refresh what we have done in lecture number 16, we did pre-writing techniques with examples. First pre-writing technique that we talked about was free writing. Then we talked about note keeping, brainstorming, mind mapping, and journalistic questions, and also some less discussed pre-writing techniques like outlining and discussing the topic with your friends or with your classmates or your teacher, thinking about the topic and exploring it by researching about it, by gathering more information, and in the end we talked about categorizing. That was more advanced kind of pre-writing strategy. This is what we did in lecture number 16. I hope this lecture has helped you a lot regarding understanding of how to gather material regarding your writing before actually starting off with writing. So this is the end of lecture number 16. We'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you very much.